So, Rav Cardoza, I want to ask you a question. Would you be able to, you have so many people who read your books and your articles over the years, and I feel very blessed to be able to sit in front of you in your home and office in Beit Vegan. So I want to ask you, would you be able to list five influential, important books about religion or philosophy or psychology that you would want to recommend to your, people who read you over the years, that you think, if you read these five books, this would have a huge impact on your life?
Yes, I would have more than five books, to be quite honest, but I can tell you what I would suggest. Now, it depends a little bit on to who you are speaking. What kind of audience are you speaking about? People who are beginners, people who are not big thinkers, or people who know much more and therefore they need different kinds of books. For the general audience, I would say as a good introduction to the Jewish tradition, which I think we are failing to have, the best thing I can come up with is Jonathan Sacks, the former chief rabbi of England, his work or his book, which is called Radical Then, Radical Now. This is a beautiful introduction to what the Jewish tradition is all about. I think it's a genius work. It is not an academic work. I think he wrote this for the wedding of one of his children, if I correctly remember. That is a beautiful way of introducing the Jewish tradition to people. I hear it has been translated in Hebrew, and I think it should be read in every secular Israeli school, because it would give them a feeling of pride why we are Jews. And he does that, as always, in a marvelous way. The second book I would suggest is also Jonathan Sacks' book, and it is called The Great Partnership. It is about science and about religion, and how he there explains what science is, what religion is. There's a lot of psychology in there. It's a marvelous book, which I tremendously enjoyed reading it. It's a piece of great work, like Jonathan Sacks. All his works are very, very good. Then I would suggest that one should read, for people who are interested in that, The Torah is Not in Heaven by Eliezer Berkowitz, which is a fantastic introduction to what halakha, in my opinion, should be. I would also suggest to read Louis Jacob's book called The Tree of Life, where he gives an overview of how halakha has developed over the years. Tremendous scholar with a lot of footnotes, which is marvelous, very well written. And I would, forgive me for saying so, also tell people to read my book called Jewish Law as a Rebellion. And I say this in humility. My other books are not so important, but this one is important. And then for people who can read Hebrew properly, I would choose for Rabbi Tzadok HaKohen, his pirush, his explanation of the five books of the Torah, called Pri HaTzadik. It's a marvelous work. Not everything there is understandable. There's some mystical stuff there which is also beyond me. But there is a broadness of mind there which I haven't seen anywhere else. And I would say to people who know how to learn, that is a book to go for. The other book I would go for is the Mehashiloach of the Ishbitzer, Rabbi Mordechai Yosef ben from Ishbitz. And then obviously, and you have written yourself about him, Rav Kook, and the Talmid of Rav Kook, the Nazir, Rabbi David Cohen. These are, for me, very important books, and I would definitely tell people, go and read them. Some of them are not easy, like Rav Kook, and you have to do that together with other people. But I think these books are the first ones I would think about.